सुपरनेटिंग इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट एंड इट इज़ द रिवर्स ऑफ सबनेटिंग. एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न दैट सबनेटिंग इज़ क्रिएटिंग मल्टीपल नेटवर्क्स फ्रॉम ए सिंगल बिग नेटवर्क. सुपरनेटिंग इज़ रिवर्स ऑफ दैट. दैट मीन्स यू आर कंबाइनिंग मल्टीपल नेटवर्क्स टू अ सिंगल नेटवर्क. यू आर नॉट डिवाइडिंग वन नेटवर्क इंटू मल्टीपल नेटवर्क्स बट यू आर कंबाइनिंग मल्टीपल नेटवर्क्स टू मेक ए बिग नेटवर्क. So in other words, you can say that converting networking bits to host bits. So in subnetting, it was converting host bits to networking bits. But in supernetting, it is converting from network bits to host bits. That means converting ones into zeros is called supernetting. So we will see the benefits why we are using that. So this is also called as classless inter-domain routing. So the supernetting is also called as CIDR. So in order to understand it, we have a scenario. You can see here there are four network entries, and these four network entries are of my branches, and these are to be advertised by my router to the corporate network. This is my corporate network out here. So now the question is, if I am going to advertise all those entries by the router or the specific or summarized entry. So supernetting is actually going to take these all four networks and going to summarize it into one network entry. This is how you are reducing the number of total network entries which are to be advertised by this router to the corporate network. So how to do that? So first of all, let me write down all four networks which I had there in the scenario. And these four networks are 192.168.0.0, 1.0, 2.0, 3.0 with /24 values. This /24 is nothing but the networking bits, that means ones. So that is basically a subnet mask for these network entries. So the steps which are required to do supernetting, the first step is write all the numbers in binary. So I need to write all these numbers into the binary. So this is the binary for this number. So how to write that? We already have discussed that. So we have the table 128, 64, 32, 16, 8, 4, 2, 1. So in order to write down the binary for 192, I need to add up these numbers so that I could get 192. So 128 plus 64, these two are making 192. That means I need to put one here and remaining I need to put zeros. So this is how I got these number, this binary number. So I need to write the binary for all four numbers. So this is the first step. So I have written down all the binaries for all the numbers. Now the next step is find matching bits left to right up to a match. Until you don't find the different number. So this step is, you have to start matching the bits from left to right up to the match, as long as it is matching. So if you look here and you compare these four numbers, you can see here that these are the bits which are matching out of these numbers. So after matching it, you have to go to the next step, and next step is write up to match the same number, whatever the number is there, write that number down plus put zero up to end. So write the same number which is the matching one and then put zero up to the end. That means completing the 32 bits. So the number which I am going to write this way is going to be my new network ID. So you can see here in this number, this is the matching part, and from there, because it is different from here, so I am changing and I am putting all those zeros there, just zeros as per this step. And if you write down the decimal equivalent to this number, that is going to be 192 for this and 168 0 and 0. So this is actually the new network ID which I am going to advertise from my topology, which I told you this scenario. So I'm going to advertise that network ID which we have calculated from this calculation by using these three steps. Now next step and the final step is that you have to make all ones up to the match. That means you have to make all ones up to the match, and then you have to put zero up to the end. So by doing this, you will be you are going to have the new subnet mask. So if you do so, then the matching bits are up to here. That means you are going to put all ones as per the step. So that is going to give you 8 ones, 8 ones and 6 ones, that is 22 ones, and the remaining zeros, completing 32-bit address. So if you write this in decimal, that is 255.255.255.0, and this is new mask going to be used with this new network ID. Now one thing to note here is that in order to get this subnet mask, you are actually having this number, 6 ones and 2 zeros. So if you calculate the decimal equivalent, that is going to be 252. From the same formula, 128 plus 64 plus 32 plus 16 plus 8 and plus 4. Now this is the last value I added in order to get this number, and this value is important to me. This value is the block size. By using this number, I am going to have next network with this mask. So we will see that in a moment. So this is the network entry, or the summarized entry, or the supernet entry with slash value of 22. That means this is the mask, new mask. So this is the entry you are going to advertise. And in this scenario, if you see, so that entry is going to be advertised by your router. Instead of advertising all four networks, it is just going to advertise just one entry. And basically it is containing all four entries behind it. So what are the benefits? If we talk about the benefits, are that you reduce the network traffic, of course, because there would be going to be advertised four networks, but now you just have one entry to advertise to the corporate network. And the second and big benefit is that it is used to minimize the size of the routing table. Of course, the routers here in the corporate network, they are going to have more burden if you don't minimize these all entries, because you may be having hundreds of networks out here, and instead of advertising all those hundreds of networks, you are just going to advertise few entries depending upon your calculation of supernetting. So these are the benefits of using supernetting. So what we conclude in this video, that supernetting is the inverse of subnetting. It is taking multiple networks and then making or summarizing them into one. And the methods to do so is that first you have to write all the binaries for all the numbers. Then you have to see, you have to look for the matching ones. Then you have to write down the new network ID. Then you have to write down the new mask, and that new mask and new ID is going to be advertised by your network to the outside boundary or the outside routers. So that summarized entry or the supernetted entry is going to be advertised. So I hope this video has been informative for you, and thank you for watching.